Welcome friends to the Formula Engineering Classroom lecture series. And now in this lecture we will talk all about fluid statics. So what is the sense of fluid statics? So in fluid static we are considering this word statics. The static word means at rest condition. We are defining this as at rest condition. Means in this section of fluid mechanics we will deal with the fluid which is at rest condition, that is fluid statics. So means in this lecture we will see what types of forces are involved when the fluid is at rest condition. So when we are talking about the forces, so let's first understand the forces in case of fluid. So the forces we can categorize in two major categories. If let we are generally categorize the forces, so I'm categorized like that. First I'm defining body force. Second I'm defining surface force. So when I'm defining forces into category like body and surface forces, so what is the sense of these forces? So means we can say that there is any mass that is essentially act upon by two category of forces, that is body forces and surface forces. Mean based on the body, that is the mass based, and another one is the surface area, that is surface based. So when we are talking about the body forces, so body forces are those which are directly proportional to the mass. In this case we can say that there is body forces are those which are directly proportional to mass. If you are talking about body forces, body forces are directly proportional to mass. Like if I'm saying that there is some fluid here in this chamber, and this fluid is in gravitational field. So due to gravitational field there is some mass, there will be a weight that is acting on this fluid. So if mass increases, the weight also increases. Means the body forces are those forces which are directly proportional to mass. Means if increment in any mass, there is also increment in the force. So we can see this one, that is weight is also a body force. So like weight, electromagnetic force is also a body force. Now surface forces are those which are basically caused by the surrounding medium. Let if I am saying there is a fluid element here, this is a fluid element, and this fluid element is surrounded by the fluid itself. Alright, due to this surrounding fluid, this surrounding fluid will exert a force on the surface area of this element. Means the surface force is completely depending on surface area. Means if surface area increases or decreases, the surface force will also increase and decreases. Doesn't matter what is the mass is, it's completely based on surface area. So means body force is completely proportional to mass, and surface force is completely proportional to surface area. The example of surface force is pressure force. So we know from the definition of pressure force, that is force upon area. So if I'm saying that is F is the pressure force, so F is P into area. So if area increases, this force also increases. So this is a surface force. Also shear force. So shear stress, we are defining shear stress is force upon area. Again if I'm defining this is shear force, so we can write shear force is equals to shear stress into shear area. So now as again the surface area increases, shear force increases. So means surface forces are completely proportional to the surface area, and body forces are proportional to mass. So now when we are talking about the fluid static, so means the fluid at rest condition, means there is no motion of fluid, or actually there is no relative velocity between the fluid layers. So if there is no relative velocity between the fluid layers, then there is no shear stress, because as we defined the definition of flow, we defined that is in that case due to the effect of shear force the fluid deforms continuously. So as there is no flow, there is no relative motion between the layers, that's why there is no shear stress. Means at rest position, at rest position or condition, shear force is zero. So means this force is out for us in case of fluid static. Also, as there is no motion, so there is no inertia here. Alright, so there is no inertia, means there is no acceleration here, so there is no inertia force here. Alright, so there is no inertia force here. So now the forces which are considerable in case of fluid statics are, first of all, the body force, that is out of all body force the one body force is the weight, and the second is the surface force, that is the pressure force. So at rest condition weight is considerable and also pressure force is considerable. So in throughout the fluid mechanics we will see these two forces. Out of these two, one is the body force, one is the surface force. So as at first I am defining weight. So we all know that is weight is equals to mass into gravitational acceleration. Alright, so if m is the mass of the fluid, let if I am saying there is a container, and in this container let m is the mass, and this mass in the gravitational field, in the earth gravitational field, so here gravitational acceleration is 9.81 meter per second square. So in that case the weight of this fluid will be simply equals to multiplication of mass and the gravitational acceleration. Alright, now so pressure, now we have to carefully understand the term pressure means. So let here I am defining what is the pressure is, and this is very important term we are defining here when we are specially discussing the fluid static, because there are some laws which are completely associated with the pressure, and in the next lectures we will see the laws and also the measurement of the pressure. There are instruments. The instruments are termed as manometers. So first that I am defining the pressure is, so let we are defining pressure. So let here I am saying that there is a chamber here, or that there is a container here, and in this container let there is some fluid. So as there is some kinetic energy of these fluid particles, they will move, they will roam around, and they will collide each other, and they will also collide the container wall. So the term pressure is basically the colliding of the molecules to each other and the walls, and this is basically the momentum transfer provided by the particles to the walls. And this is in nature, that is it will provide a normal force intensity to the container wall. Means if you are saying let P is the pressure in this chamber, in this container, so we are defining this arrow is P. So we are defining प्रेशर इट्स जस्ट दैट दैट इज प्रेशर इज द फोर्स इंटेंसिटी और इट्स सिंपली फोर्स अपॉन यूनिट एरिया. सो दिस इज द फोर्स इंटेंसिटी और दिस इज बेसिकली दिस फोर्स इज द नॉर्मल फोर्स. Normal force. This force will always act normal to the surface. So as we defined, the pressure is a surface force. Or pressure is a surface force intensity. So area increases. In that case, the pressure force, that is this normal force, will also increases. So pressure is a normal force intensity. That is due to the molecular momentum of the molecules. So if let I'm saying, if I'm installing some pump here or some device here, that will remove this fluid from this chamber. So let I'm saying, let 10% of this fluid is out of the chamber. So in that case, the momentum or the force transfer to the container wall is also reduced by this much amount, that is by 10%. Now similarly, if I'm saying this is 25%, so also this pressure intensity is also reduced by 25% amount. If let I'm saying this is 100% fluid is out from this chamber, so in that case there is no particle of this fluid in this container. That's why there is no momentum, that's why no colliding, that's why there is no pressure. So this state, when there is no particle is there, is termed as absolute zero state. Absolute zero state or absolute zero pressure means in that case, when the 100% fluid is out, means there is no particles of fluid is available here. This state is absolute zero pressure. So as let if I am saying for the earth, so our earth is look like earth, right? So our earth is surrounded by air. And we are termed this one is atmosphere. This air is stick to this earth is due to the earth gravity. The earth gravity, this air is stick to the earth here. So as we are defining the atmospheric pressure, so what is atmospheric pressure is? So we can say that there is the intensity of the particle surrounding the earth, enveloping the earth, is such that it is exerting a normal force to the earth surface. Exerting a normal force to the earth surface. This normal force intensity per unit area of the earth surface is termed as atmospheric pressure. And we know this value is around, that if I'm doing, that is P atmospheric is around, it's 101325 Newton per meter square. Or for the Newton per meter square, we can also use the term Pascal. So this is the value of atmospheric pressure. So we can say that there is the intensity of the air particles is such that there is the momentum transfer to the earth surface or normal force intensity is this much. That is 101325 Newton per meter square. So means if I'm comparing this much of pressure compared to this absolute zero, so we can create a scale here. So let I'm saying this is the line at which the pressure is absolute zero. So I'm saying this is absolute zero line. All right. So comparing to this one, I can say that the atmospheric pressure is around this much. This value is P atmospheric. This much. Here the pressure intensity is zero. Here the pressure intensity is, that I'm saying this is P atmospheric, and that I'm saying this value is equals to 1 atm. This is 1 atmospheric pressure. All right. So for this scale, when we are comparing this atmospheric pressure to the absolute zero, that's why we are defining this much of intensity of this pressure. So any pressure which we are comparing to this absolute zero line is termed as absolute pressure. You can define it, this is absolute pressure. Means atmospheric pressure is a absolute pressure because we are comparing this pressure with respect to the absolute zero line. Means if let I'm saying this atmospheric pressure is for Earth, and let if I'm saying for other planet like Mars, if we are saying that, if I'm saying, I don't know what is the exact value of Mars atmospheric pressure, but if I'm saying this much, this is P atmospheric of Mars. So in that case, this pressure is also absolute pressure if we are comparing this pressure, this atmospheric pressure of Mars, with respect to absolute zero. So any pressure we are comparing with absolute zero line is termed as absolute pressure. Now as this atmospheric pressure is all over the Earth, so let if I'm saying there is a chamber here, or let there is a container here, and this container, again let I'm saying there is some gas or some fluid here, and let I have some measuring instrument, and when I'm attaching the instrument to measurement of the pressure in this chamber, it's showing some reading, let I'm saying it's showing 2. And when that instrument is not attached this chamber and it's free to atmosphere, that instrument is showing 1. Means this time this instrument is open to atmosphere, simply it is not attached to this chamber, it's showing 1. But when I'm attaching this instrument to this chamber, it is showing 2. So means actually when this is open to atmosphere, normally this is in normal atmosphere, and it's showing 1, so it's showing the atmospheric pressure is 1, that is 1 atmospheric. And when I'm attaching this instrument to this one, this container, in that case when the readings are 2, means we can say that it is around here. So let I'm saying this value is 2, this value is 1, this value is 2, because for the atmosphere it's showing 1, so I'm saying this is 1, and for this container it's showing 2, so this is 2 here. So this 2, if I'm comparing, actually not comparing, if I'm measuring, because this 2 is the state of the pressure from this absolute zero, so actually this pressure is also absolute pressure. Alright, now as I said, that is atmospheric pressure is everywhere on this Earth. So I want to prepare new scale. So now let the atmospheric pressure is zero for me. Now the atmospheric pressure is zero for me, and I'm comparing this 2 value compared to this 1 value. Now this pressure is not absolute pressure because my scale start from this atmospheric pressure, and we termed this value is gauge pressure. This is gauge pressure. Means if I calibrate this instrument and after the calibration, when I will put this instrument into atmosphere, it will show zero. Means it's considering that is atmospheric pressure is zero for me. Atmospheric pressure is zero for me. Now when I will attach this instrument to this chamber, now it will show the one. So now this one is not absolute. This one is gauge pressure. So now we are preparing a scale. If we are measuring the pressure from absolute zero pressure line, then the pressure will be absolute pressure, like that. But if we are measuring the pressure from this one atmospheric line, then the pressure will be gauge pressure. Now this pressure may be positive gauge or negative gauge. Means, let if I'm saying this line, so that for this line, if I'm saying this is the absolute pressure, and if let I'm considering this atmospheric is 1, so let I'm saying this is 0.75. So means this is showing the absolute pressure of that particular chamber. Let I'm saying again, this taking on this chamber, there is fluid here, so this is the state of the pressure in this chamber, and in this chamber it's showing that that is absolute pressure is 0.75. but when I'm comparing this line to this line, so this pressure is actually gauge pressure, but negative gauge pressure. This is negative gauge pressure and this is positive gauge pressure. Means for this line, this pressure is more than the atmospheric pressure, that is much this value, and this value is showing that this much is the less pressure. This is the less pressure than compared to the atmospheric. This is negative gauge. Negative gauge is also termed as vacuum pressure, right? Negative gauge is also termed as vacuum pressure. So this value will be, so if this is 0.75, so this remaining value will be 0.25, because this is 1 from here to here. This is 0.75, so this is 0.25. so for this chamber, I can say that that is P absolute is 0.75. you can use the units. And also this is also same case, that is this is absolute value, the gauge is 0.25, but this value is negative 1. Means this chamber has minus 0.25 vacuum pressure or 0.75 absolute pressure. Alright, so this is the scale for the pressure. So let I'm summarizing this one. This is the state of pressure when there is no particles. That's why the pressure is absolute zero. And this is our atmospheric pressure. And according to the intensity of air surrounding the earth, we are saying that this is one atmospheric. So compared to this absolute zero, we are here on the earth. So any pressure that I'm measuring, taking this one as a standard line, so if let I'm saying this one, so this is termed as absolute one. But if I'm taking standard line this one, so in that case the pressure above and below this one is termed as gauge pressure. And if the pressure is above the atmospheric pressure, this will be positive gauge pressure. And if the pressure is below this line, it will be negative gauge pressure or vacuum pressure. All right, now we know there is one more term used for atmospheric pressure. One more convention here, you can also write, there is P atmospheric is also equals to 760 mm of Hg. So what is the sense of this term? So let we are conducting an experiment here. Let there is a jar here, container here, and in this container the fluid is mercury. This fluid is mercury. Now let here I'm taking one tube, right? I'm taking one tube here, and let there's an opening here, and let I'm installing a suction device here. So as initially when the suction device is at rest and start working, in that case we can say that the pressure inside this closed tube is atmospheric pressure. Right, let here the pressure is atmospheric pressure, as there is air inside this one. This is P atmospheric, and the pressure over the surface is also atmospheric pressure. Is also atmospheric pressure, right? So means here, here and here the pressure is same, there is atmospheric pressure. Now let's start the suction device. So now let I'm saying it removes 25% of air inside this one. So it's obvious when suction will happen, this liquid will start to rise due to suction effect. This will start to rise here, alright. So as this liquid rises, we can consider here the pressure will remain same, that is atmospheric pressure, but the top layers of the fluid in this tube, above the top layer of the fluid in this tube, the pressure is only 75% of atmospheric pressure. It's 0.75 times of P atmospheric, as 25% is out here. So if you are considering this surface, that is exactly in the level of fluid outside this tube, so above this one top layer of fluid the pressure is 0.75 times of atmospheric, and this height, due to height of this mercury over this layer, is providing a weight that is acting in downward direction, due to which the pressure intensity at this surface is exactly equal to 1 atmospheric pressure. That's why this is in equilibrium state. So 0.75% is the atmospheric pressure here, and remaining 25% is due to the weight of the mercury. Here again the pressure is atmospheric pressure in the tube. Outside the tube, yes, there is atmospheric pressure because there is air is acting here. Now if I am saying this suction device remove 100% of air from this chamber, so this will rise more. And I'm saying up to this point, so above this one there is no air. If there is no air here, the pressure is absolute zero. Here the pressure is absolute zero, means at this layer the pressure intensity is provided by the weight of this mercury above this one, means the height of the mercury in this tube is this much. This will exactly provide the pressure intensity at this surface is equal to the atmospheric pressure. So to do this experiment, if you measure this height will be 760 mm. This height is 760 mm. and from this our from scale system. Here what is the pressure? Here the pressure is absolute zero. So again we are comparing, here the pressure is atmospheric pressure due to the weight of the mercury. So again we are comparing at this point the pressure with respect to the absolute zero state. So this is the atmospheric pressure here. So we are defining the pressure in terms of height of mercury, that is 760 m of mercury. Now if you will do the same experiment, but instead of mercury if you are taking water, if there is water, so for that experiment the height of the water will be 10.33 meter. So 10.33 meter, not mm, meter of water. So means you can also define P atmospheric is also equal to 10.33 meter of mercury. This is ideal case. So similarly you can define the atmospheric pressure in terms of any fluid height. But why for the different fluid the height is different for the same atmospheric pressure? We will see this concept in the next lecture. Till then, take care of yourself. Thanks for watching.